we will continue with the VLOOKUP function. In cell area B4 to D12, we can see the fuel consumption and the cost in dollars for certain distances calculated in miles. For example, for a 75-mile journey, we need 10 liters of gasoline, which cost $13. Let's suppose you want to look up the consumption in liters for a 100-mile journey and show it in cell H14. In such a small pool of data, it is relatively easy to find the proper value and manually type it in the proper cell. Imagine if your data spanned to thousands of rows and columns. Finding out the needed value then could be impossible. This is where Excel's lookup functions provide us with a solution. So, in cell H14, we will use the VLOOKUP function to get the value we need. The VLOOKUP function searches the data of the first column on the left of the cell area B4 to D12 for a value. In our case, it's 100 miles, and returns the value of the cell that can be found at the same row and at the given column of the cell area. In our case, the column is the second one, and so the value is 15. We select the cell and navigate to the Formulas tab. We click at Insert Function and set the category to Lookup and Reference. We locate the VLOOKUP function there and click OK. We can, of course, just type the name of the function after the equal sign. At the arguments window, we set the values that we are looking for at the lookup value. We select the cell F14, which refers to the distance that we are looking for, the 100 miles. At the field table array, we need to define the cell area where Excel will perform the search. This is the cell area B4 to D12. At the argument call index num, we define the column number where the liters are displayed. In our case, this is the second column, so we type the value 2. The last field contains only two options, true or false. We can type the number 1 or 0 respectively. If we type the number 0, Excel will only look for an exact match. In case there is no such value, Excel will display an error message. If we type number 1 and there is not an exact match, Excel will find the lower closest match in the first column. In our case, it would be 75. We need to note that in order to use this function with a last attribute set to 1, the cell area needs to be sorted in ascending order by the column miles in which you want to look for the value. Since we now need an exact match, we type 0 and click on OK. As a result, the value 15 will be shown, which corresponds to 100 miles, as you can see in our example. If we change the value of the cell F14 to 110 miles, we can see that an error message appears because there aren't any values available for 110 miles. In this case, we should change the last attribute in the formula bar to 1. This will still return us 15 because the lower closest match to 110 is 100. The letter V at VLOOKUP stands for vertical, so VLOOKUP looks for a value, in our case 100, at the first column of a cell area, in our case, this cell area, and when it finds it, it returns the value that is found at a cell with the same vertical position and on the right of the first column. In our example, we have asked for the second column. That's why we had the result 15. In case we had asked for the third column, would we have the result $19.5?